Good morning all. So in the previous lecture that we have actually discussed about the derivation related to the high speed cornering as well as the Ackermann steering, that means when the vehicle taking a turn at low speed. Then after we have discussed the two different speeds, that is actually known as characteristic speed, and the second one is known as a cornering speed. So characteristic speed, basically we talked about when we have the understeer gradient, and critical speed basically we considered for the oversteer gradient. So critical speed basically representing it for the unstable cases, and the characteristic speed basically we talking about for the steady state case. Now in this lecture basically we talking about the steady state cornering related numerical. That means how to calculate the gradients, what types of problem can be asked. In the last lecture I gave you one question just as a homework to solve this. The same thing I'm going to solve here. Okay, now the question is, a fully loaded light truck has a property shown below. So this is a truck, you also, this is the rear and the front and the rear side. At the front side the total load is 9000 newton and the rear side the total load is 10500 newton. CG height is 923 mm. That means this is the height from the CG to the ground floor. Wheelbase is representing up to 3 meter, and the tire cornering coefficient is given. This is a table that is actually given in the equation. So that table basically representing the different values of load and different cornering stiffness. So in this question that has been asked, what is the Ackermann steering angle? Steer angle in the 50 meter radius turn. First thing that has been asked. Second, what is the understeer gradient due to the tire cornering stiffness? Third thing, during the braking of the longitudinal load transfer contributes oversteer. What is the understeer gradient due to the cornering stiffness at 0.5g braking deacceleration? Okay, so the acceleration part is given here. And the last one, we are asking, what is the critical speed for this level of oversteer braking system? That means this part is actually a part of this C1. That means we need to calculate the understeer gradient from here, and that gradient has to be used in this critical speed formula. That means on the basis of that oversteer, we need to calculate this critical speed. Now coming with the first part has been asked, calculate the Ackermann steer angle. So we already know what is the formula of Ackermann steering, that is the 57.3 L by R plus alpha F minus alpha R. Alpha F and alpha R is nothing, it's just a slip angle at the front and the rear side. So when we talking about the slip angle, now he is asking in this question, calculate the Ackermann steer angle. So Ackermann steer angle basically we need to calculate always be at the low speed. So what is the slip angle at the low speed? We already know the low speed slip angle always be a zero, or we can say it is negligible. So there is no effect of alpha F and alpha R over the steer angle when we talking about at low speed. So the finally what formula basically we left, we need to put alpha F and alpha R is equals to zero. That means it becomes a negligible in this case. The final formula we have 57.3 into L by R. So this is the formula basically it is left. L representing what? It is the wheelbase, it is already given in the question. It is given 3 meter. You can check, it is given here. It is a given 3 meter. And R representing is the radius turn. So it is given here in the question, it is a 50 meter. So simply put this value and simplify it, we got the first answer. So that is representing as the steer angle. So it is coming 3.438 degree. Now coming to the second part. In the second part that has been asked, calculate the understeer gradient due to the tire cornering stiffness. Now how to calculate this understeer gradient due to the tire cornering stiffness? In this part basically we require this table. So this table is already given in the equation. That means a different load respect to the different cornering stiffness is given. So here the load, we need to identify what has been given in the equation. Accordingly we need to identify the cornering stiffness. How? See it. See, what is the total front side load is given? 9000 newton. This is also a given value in the equation. And total rear side load is given 10500 newton. So this is the front side total load and this is the rear side total load. Now here I am talking about what is the total load at front side per tire. So that becomes the half of this one. That means front side two tires are there, that is actually distributed equally. That is 4500 at one tire and 4500 at the other tire. Same case at the rear side, the total load is 10,500 newton. So here the load becomes 5,250 newton per tire. So this is the individual load acting at a single tire. So what we need to do next, I need to identify the cornering stiffness on the basis of this front load as well as for the rear loads. Let us suppose we need to calculate the cornering stiffness for the front load. So what is the magnitude here? 4500 newton per tire. So check, what is the load here? So this 4500 basically comes in between 4000 and 5000 newton. So we need to use some interpolation method. So what is the interpolation method? It is given here. So we need to use an interpolation method to determine the cornering stiffness for the front as well as for the rear tires. So this expression has to be used. Y minus y1 is equals to x2 y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. The same formula has to be used here. So here this load basically representing for my case it is x, this representing in terms of y. So what is x1 and what is x2, what is y1 and what is y2? Okay, now see it here. So first of all I'm talking about for the front wheel or front tire load. So in front tire load, why we need to calculate, that means the tire cornering stiffness at 4500 newton. Y1 basically representing here the lowest value of the stiffness between the given range. Y2 representing here the highest range between the given cornering stiffness. X1 is 4000, X2 is 5000. That means whatever the parameter you are able to see between that values lie, that representing lie X1 and X2 and Y1 and Y2. So this is Y1, Y2, this is X1, X2. Got it? Now finally, what is my X here? X representing here the value on which we want to calculate the cornering stiffness. So I know the value, it is actually coming in between of that one, that is 4500 newton per tire. The same has to be used here. So finally, put these values Y1, Y2, X1, X2 and X. Finally, one unknown quantity is there. So whatever the quantity you actually got, directly you will get from here. That means you will get the value of C alpha F. In a same manner, I need to calculate C alpha R. In C alpha R, that means the load is given 5250 newton per meter. So this value basically coming in between these two numbers and these two range. So in that situation, that becomes my Y1, Y2. This becomes my X1, X2. Okay? And the X becomes my 5250. Y basically we need to calculate. So same manner, we need to calculate the overall load. So simply you can see here y is equals to this is actually unknown. Y1 is 750, y2 is 780, x1 is 5000, x2 is 6000 and x is 5250. So in the same manner calculate the C alpha R. So we got two values, C alpha F as well as the C alpha R. So both are the cornering stiffness at the front and the rear side, as well as two terms you are able to see here in this formula, WFS and WRS, that is representing the load factor at the front side and the rear side. So front side load becomes 4500 per tire and rear side that becomes 5250 newton per tire. Okay, so finally what has been asked in the question, calculate the understeer gradient. So what is the formula of understeer gradient that we already seen previously? That is the expression to calculate the understeer gradient, WFS upon C alpha F minus WRS upon C alpha R. So put all the values C alpha F and C alpha R as per the interpolation method and alpha S, and these two values already given. Simplify it here and this will be the answer. So here you can see the answer is actually coming in terms of negative. What is negative representing here? It is representing here the understeer gradient is representing, that means there is a condition of understeer is going on. That means there is no oversteer gradient is going on. So here this k value, if it is negative, that representing a understeer case. If it is more than 0, that becomes the oversteer case. If it is equal to 0, that becomes a neutral case. So as per our case, it is coming understeering is going on. That means the constant value we actually got 0.742 in negative degree per g. G is in the acceleration due to gravity. So this is the second part that we have calculated. Now coming to the third part. In the third part, he is asking calculate the braking, during the braking the longitudinal load transfer contributes oversteer. That means the condition is already given, there is a oversteering is going on. So what is the understeer gradient? Do not get confused, understeer gradient is not, I am talking about the understeering condition. Understeer gradient is a common term has been used either for the oversteer as well as for the understeer. Understeer gradient means I am talking about a K term, that's it. Due to the tire cornering stiffness at 0.5 g braking deacceleration. The 0.5 g is nothing, it's just a acceleration has been given here. So what I'm using, I am finally calculating the k during the oversteer. So how to calculate the K in that situation? Now see, when the braking has been applied, so that means at the front side load acts more as compared to the rear side. How we say how much load actually acting at the front side as well as the rear side? So see this expression, total load actually at the front side is the load acting at the front side. So how much load that is in the given in the question? 9000 newton for both tires plus mass into acceleration. So this is the force basically acting at the front side. In the rear side load minus mass into acceleration. So this is actually a mass into acceleration. What is this? Can we write mass W by G? Okay, and A representing W by G into H by L. So here W by G into H by L is nothing, is representing the partial mass which is actually acting at the front side, and W by G into H by L representing a partial mass basically acting at the rear side. So overall mass basically acting at the front side, it is in addition form, and the rear side is in subtraction form. So overall load WFS plus WAH upon GL, and that becomes WRS minus WAH upon GL. So simplify it here, W, it is representing what? The total load on the vehicle. Total load means addition of front as well as the rear load. So front side load is given 9000 and the rear side load is given 10,500. Add these two terms, how much we got? 19,500. This is the value of W. Into acceleration is already given in the question, it is 0.5g. So directly I am putting 0.5g. So g, so g will get cancelled out, and h is, it is the height of the cg from the ground floor, it is already given 0.923. and length means the wheelbase is already given 3 meter. So simplify this complete term, you will get the force actually acting at the front side, it becomes 12,000 newton. So this is 12,000 newton for the complete front side. So if I'm talking about at the single tire, how much load actually acting, it is a 6000 newton per tire. In the same manner, calculate for the rear side. So finally we'll get an expression, 7500 newton for the overall side at the rear. Now at the individual tire, they become 3750 newton per tire. Same as like the case number B. That means in a number B, we actually calculating the understeer gradient using a tire cornering stiffness. So we actually using the same table, same interpolation method to calculate C alpha f and C alpha r. In that situation, for front side, that becomes my x. For alpha r f, C alpha r, basically that becomes my x. Same manner, that means suppose I am talking about for 6000. So 6000 basically Cummings is already having a 780. So in that situation, we have not to calculate the this tire cornering stiffness using interpolation method, because this is a direct value you are able to see. At 6000 the value is 780 newton per degree. But in second case it is 3750. So see, 3750 basically coming within this range. To apply the same concept, this becomes my x1, this becomes my x2, this becomes my y1, this becomes my y2, and x becomes my 3750 newton per tire. So calculate again by using this method, C alpha r. Again, they asking calculate the understeer gradient. So that means again we need to use the same formula. So that formula basically will give you the final expression here, that will give you minus 1.923 degree per g. So here this again it is coming negative, that representing what? It is representing the value of understeer gradient. So finally what we need to do, I need to calculate the next expression. That means a critical speed. How to calculate the critical speed? So critical speed for the oversteer, we need to calculate by using a formula. V critical is equals to under root minus 57.3 LG by K. So here we already see the value of K, we actually got it as a negative. And here the expression also having a negative. So negative, negative get positive. So simplify, put the value. L is 3 meter. G is 9.81 meter per second square. And K is 1.923. Minus and minus will get negative, and simplify this complete term, you got 29.6 meter per second. So this is representing here the critical speed of the vehicle during the overturning. Oversteering actually. So this is the complete question that actually asks all four terms. What is Ankerman steering? That what is the understeer gradient during tire cornering stiffness? During a braking condition, calculate the gradient coefficient. And what is the critical speed during that condition? So all things that has been calculated here in the same manner, we got the final answer. Doubt? Clear? So any doubt basically we have, so please let me know over the LPU live. So this is the problem. This is your homework that has to be solved by yourself. So read this question. A fully loaded truck has a front and the rear axle load is 96,000 newton and the 14,000 newton respectively. The CG height is 900 mm and the wheelbase is 3 meter. Again, the tire corner stiffness table is given. Only one thing is going to calculate the understeer gradient due to the tire cornering stiffness. So this is your homework. Try to solve it by yourself. So if you have any doubt, then let me ask you some problems. Okay, thank you.